Hey everyone, the name is Erik Thor, and I know there is probably nothing worse than a person who brags incessantly about what they do or what they have accomplished. Often we are all struggling with the people in our lives that feel a need to shove what they do down your throat, to feel a need to speak about what they do in a way that kind of gets you down, that makes you feel bad about yourself and who you are, because they are always so intent on showing their best side to everyone else. And we have this problem on Facebook, we have this problem with people in our real life, people who are constantly posting pictures about everything amazing they're doing, and people who are always constantly talking about themselves and how good they are and what they have done. And there is a problem here, and the problem is that we are often misreading the people that are bragging, and we are often misinterpreting the reason why they are doing it. We often assume that people who are bragging do it because they are proud over what they do in their life, and that would be great if they were actually feeling good about what they did. That would be awesome. The problem that I find is the people who brag are actually people who aren't proud over what they do. The people who don't feel that innate sense that they have done something good often feel a higher need to brag in order to get other people's approval. It's the quality of approval seeking, sometimes wrongly confused with being an extroverted feeling type, that gets people to feel a little annoyed. And the real reason behind bragging is not related to any personality type. It's not that any personality type needs to brag to be happy. On the contrary, I think a person who is bragging is somewhat unfulfilled in their personality type. A person who brags can be a feeling type that has worked very hard and who has developed their thinking function very hard while neglecting their needs as a feeling type. A person who brags could be a thinking type that has worked very hard to develop themselves in a feeling field, but who has somewhat in this felt very unfulfilled because they have acted like feeling types. They have fought for the values of a feeler when in general they prefer to be thinking types, and they have thinking values and thinking motivations at their core. The people who forget their inner core motivation often become reliant on the environment to give them motivation. We have people in the world who are constantly clinging themselves to outer motivation factors. It can be work, it can be salaries, it can be popularity, it can be likes on YouTube, it can be subscribers, it can be anything in this world. And generally, external motivation factors are bad. Often they leave us feeling that good sense of yay for a second, but then over the longer term it becomes highly taxing on a person. Most famous people can feel this tug because they realize that they have been serving this outer parent of the comment field, or of the people who like them, or of their family, or someone else, and they have completely forgotten about themselves in the process. The process of, like, what do you find personally fulfilling? When you experience personal fulfillment, or the personal feeling of, wow, I have done something good, yes, sometimes you will feel called to share that happiness and joy with other people. You will be really happy over it meeting a certain goal or accomplishing something. But if it isn't intrinsically fulfilling, that's when you feel the need to compensate by bragging and by boosting it up and making it seem bigger than it is, and sometimes making other people feel bad about themselves. And it can happen very easily that a person who isn't feeling intrinsically fulfilled will feel bad when other people are succeeding, because they will have that feeling that whenever other people are succeeding and they aren't, they are being left behind, and they are at risk of losing their support from these people. And you're starting to make more money, then you don't want to be my friend anymore because I'm not good enough for you. And it can be like this crazy tug, because we should all not be caring about things like money. There is no type that should find money inherently fulfilling. There is no type that should find popularity or likes or comments to be inherently fulfilling. Obviously, a thinking type is somebody who values achievement, that sense that, wow, I have met the challenge, I've learned something new, I've improved myself, I have become better as a person. That's the thinking core value. And a thinking extrinsic value, that's something different. That's not something that a thinking type inherently values. An extrinsic value is that someone else says you have learned something, someone else tells you you have done a good job, someone else says that you have improved, even if you don't feel that you have improved. And that's the crazy thing. You can feel like you are just the same person and other people can go, wow, you're so amazing. And if you don't feel that on your own, then it's not gonna feel good for you. It's only going to bring up that feeling of, oh, everyone else thinks I've done such a good job, but it just makes us more aware of how little we feel like we have done. And the same goes for feeling intrinsic value. There is an inherent motivation in feeling types to help other people, to do something good for the world, to fight for a cause, to help somebody, to make some difference in a person's life, or to improve someone else's experience, to entertain someone, to make someone happy. And the problem is that you have to feel for your sake that you have done something good. And if it becomes a feeling extrinsic value, then it's not fulfilling anymore. Then it's measuring how well-liked you are by hearing other people compliment you, by seeing other people smile, or by seeing other people's likes. Like, the question is, do you feel on the inside that you have done something good, or do you feel it on the outside? And the fascinating thing I've found is that feeling types that are acting on extrinsic motivation sources are often going to appear more like thinking types. And thinkers who act on extrinsic instead of intrinsic values are often going to appear more like feeling types. A thinker who has spent their life living like pursuing feeling motivations, pursuing extrinsic motivation sources, is going to feel inherently unfulfilled by what they do. And they're going to feel a big need to brag about it constantly, because they will feel starved. At any second when their likes aren't good enough, or when their popularity isn't good enough, they're going to feel that tug to get more. I'm not happy, I'm not satisfied. And you never will be when the source is extrinsic. Generally, to achieve that long-term source that I'm a good person, I've done something great, I'm proud of my life and my accomplishments, that's quality that you can only feel long-term on the inside. And so, sometimes I think we are all prone to mistyping these people. I think it's easy to confuse a person's motivations. And it's often the stereotype that feeling extroverts are somehow bound by this, and that feeling introverts are the ones that feel good on the inside, where feeling extroverts need to feel good on the outside. That's not actually what tends to be the real factor here. In general, there is a difference between an extrinsic motivation source and to be an extrovert. And the difference here is that an extrovert will want to make their feelings on the inside something objective. And in general, an introverted feeling type will want to make an objective experience to a part of the subject. It's just a difference in the process or the approach, but the core remains the same. We all need to pursue inner motivation sources, inner fulfillment. And the core way to get there, or the way to get there, that's up to you and who you are and what you feel good about. But there is no type that feels happy pursuing purely extrinsic motivation sources. No person is going to feel good purely acting towards something on the outside, because you can never reach the outside. The point with outside is that the outside is always going to be outside of you. It's never going to be you. And we, as a result, that's why we don't feel fulfilled. Because we don't feel a part of the world. The world is always going to be inside of us. The more we try to live outside of ourselves, the less connected we will be to what makes us truly happy. And then that sets the core here. What we all need to do is we need to find a way to be true to ourselves. No matter what type we are, we need to be true to ourselves, to our needs, to what makes us happy, to what motivates us. And we need to make sure not to get confused by the people who act on the outside and who are so preoccupied with the outside. And we need not to feel obligated to give the people who are asking us of these things also what they want. If another person is highly dependent on outside factors, that can sometimes cause you to feel a need to give them that outside gratification. If they seem to beg for compliments, we can feel like we must give them a compliment. But no, that's not gonna help them. It's not gonna be the way to get them to feel more connected to themselves. What you can do instead is, when someone is asking for attention or for appreciation, what you can do is ask them, so you do feel good about that, or did that feel good for you, or did you like that, or did you enjoy that? That's a great way to reframe the question from you giving them what they want, from finding, letting them get themselves what they want, and letting them find that inner sense of joy and gratitude over what they do. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, share, subscribe, or don't. That's all for now. I hope you enjoyed this video, and may your neurons be with you.